Yeah, Bill here. Well, we're working on our renovations again here. I've got another project on the go here as well as my hobby room. I'm currently renovating the bathroom downstairs. I started this last summer there when I took the floor out and gutted this room here, and now it's time to put it back together. I've done a little bit of framing, a little bit of drywalling, replaced my had my electrical replaced here, and now we're putting the room back together here. I'm working today on a vanity. We're going to build the vanity base, and we're also going to frame in a linen closet as well, and also a little alcove for the kitty litter box. Okay, so one of the first things we've had to do here is cut off this old pipe coming up through the floor, and that's well, that was initially put in for a shower or something like that. We're not going to be using that that kind of drain. Instead, what we're going to be doing is the plumber will be putting a hole through the wall and going back to the main stack, which is the proper way to do this. Kind of thing for a sink here. So it's kind of funny, when we moved in here, the people that had had this property before, they simply had stuck a pipe on top of here and put a trap on. They didn't glue it or anything, and of course it leaked, and we had rotten mildewy sink base, which is vanity base, which is why we did this whole renovation in the first place, because the whole place just got wrecked from water leaking out of this improper connection. So we're just going to take that off completely, and now I'm going to stuff a rag down here and put some cement over that, and that'll be the end of that hole. And then we're just going to build our vanity base around that and go from there. Okay, before we can put our little frame down here, we need to plug this hole. So basically just take a rag and fold it up, and we're just going to roll it up a bit here. The idea of the rag here is just to stop the cement from going too far down the pipe, because you don't want it to go down so far it fouls up the main line. So we're just going to stuff that down the hole here, and we're just going to put it in a couple of inches, and that's probably far enough. And once we've got that done, I'm just going to take some cement powder. This is Quantitop XS. This is a patching compound. It's polymer modified, and it's got everything it needs in it. I don't have to add any sand or gravel or anything to it, so it's just basically add water and go. And we just want to add enough water to turn this into a little bit of a paste here, slurry type paste. And this stuff here is actually very, very fast setting. I've got probably less than 10 minutes to work with this batch once I add water to it. So just a little bit more. Still a little stiff at the bottom there. So more. that's probably sufficient. If you happen to make a little bit too much, then just bring it over the top here and smooth it out on the rest of the cement. But I think we pretty much got her here. Notice that I'm using just a craft stir stick and a styrofoam cup. That's all disposable stuff, so you don't want to be putting any of this stuff down your drain, because that'll foul your drain completely. So that's in there, we'll just go like that, and we can secure this in place now. Not going to move. Okay, our platform is nice and level, which is what I expected. However, one thing that's always particularly annoying when you're doing renovations is that things in the original house are rarely, if ever square. Now, I know my board is square here, but I've got a gap here, and if I put my board right up against the drywall here, now I've got a gap over here. So I need to figure out which way is out of square. Now, I built my platform, I dropped the base on. Now this is going to be the bottom of the cupboard. And I've allowed for a two inch overhang for the toe. And now if I measure there, I've got 2 inches here, but if I measure here, I've just over 2 inches. So I know that this here's the corner that's out. So if I put that right there, push that back up against the wall, now I'm at my 2 inches where I should be. I've got my gap over here again, and since this is slightly overhanging on here, that tells me it's this corner here that's out of square. So if I just take my saw and just buzz that off about an eighth of an inch or so, I should be fine. Okay, so what I did was I just took my skill saw and I just buzzed off from here, just kind of went at a bit of an angle from zero down to about just a little over a quarter, in around a quarter of an inch. And we're just going to plunk that in, and voila, we're nice and square, we're nice and tight, and we have our 2 inches of toe. Just like we planned. So that's exactly what I wanted there. Okay, now with this piece sitting in here square and flush all around, then the next thing we need to take care of is building our framing up to the bottom of the top of the cabinet counter where the sink is going to fit. So just measure up to our line here. Now our line's at 32 inches off the floor, which is a comfortable height for a sink. So we've got 27 and a half inches there. Now I want to allow about 3/8 of an inch, or about half an inch for tiling. I'm roughly, it doesn't have to be exact here. So we'll give it. Half an inch. It allows for a 3/8 inch thick tile and some mortar, and so we'll go with 27 is where we want to build the top of our counter to, and that'll give us a half inch for tile. And okay, so we'll build that to 27, and basically, we're just gonna build a box frame in here to support this end, and then a modified box frame for this edge. And we have to have a piece coming across the front, and of course the back to support the counter all the way around. Now we do need to allow for the sink, which is kind of big for the area. Now our sink is 17 by 20 inches, so we do have to allow for the sink to have space. So what we're going to do, instead of running our 2x4s in traditional fashion level, we're going to flip them, and that'll give us a little more room on the inside underneath the counter for the sink to go in. The framing for the bottom part of the Vanity all finished. Just going to take a few minutes, and I'm going to do some drywalling in here, because it's easier to access before I put the top on, and then I'll just have to worry about mudding it later. But at least it'll be easier to screw it into place. Okay, now to cut notches and whatnot out of drywall, simply score it. Take one of these drywall knives, keyhole knife, and just simply cut down. Fit. see if these will fit. Okay, I've got my first piece of drywall here. We're just gonna slip it in here and see if everything fits fine. We're just gonna bring it up and a little snug at the back there. There we go. That works. I might have to cut that down just a bit more there. And this is just a little high, so we'll just mark that off and back to the trimming area here. Okay. Now, with just a little bit of trimming, it fits nice and snug. It's just the way we want it. Get the other piece in here. And voila, that fits perfectly as well. So we'll screw those into place and carry on here. And finally, just take a drywall rasp to the top here and just smooth off any rough places that might pop up above the surface here. And now we're ready to build the top. After installing my pieces of drywall in the kitty alcove, the next thing to do is to go cut my countertop. And I've already done that, so we'll just put that into place. The next step is going to be to build the linen closet. So now with the linen closet, we're just going to extending a wall on both sides here up to the ceiling, and then we're going to be left with this spot right here on the counter in front. We'll thicken this up with a couple layers of plywood, and then what we're going to be doing is we'll be tiling this whole area. Now, before we build the linen closet though, what we need to do is we need to get our sink, and we need to cut our hole for our sink and make sure it fits, so that when it comes time to tile, that's all in place. It's a lot easier to cut the hole for the sink when the countertop is loose and you can move it and whatever. And yeah, I can cut it while it's in place, but just a lot easier when I can move it. So let's just go do that now. The simplest way to find out how to cut your hole for your sink is just to place the sink on the countertop upside down and measure out where exactly you want to place the sink and put it in position, and then just simply draw a line around it. Once you've got that line around it, just simply take a tape measure and then note the 1-inch mark, and just go around the entire perimeter and mark off a series of dashes that you can join together or follow with the jigsaw later. And you want to cut 1 inch inside of this outer rim, and that we'll leave room for the widest place, and once that's cut, then the sink will just drop into the hole. With the countertop in place, the easiest way to cut this out is with a jigsaw, and basically you just start out like with the jigsaw like this, and get the blade running, and then slowly turn it so that it cuts into the edge, and that's how you get it started. Now the other way is to just drill a hole, and take a drill if you got one handy, and just start a hole. But this will work just as well. And that's how you break through the surface. Now once you've got your hole, in you go, and just follow your dots all the way around, and you've got her made. Mm-hmm. Okay, so now if we've done this somewhat accurately, that sink should just drop right in here. Okay. Now that's good for now. That can just stay there and we'll continue on with the rest of the construction. We'll have to pull it out to tile, but once we've tiled, then the plumber can come in and hook everything up for us and that'll be all done. Okay, now we'll just give this a quick tacking down to make sure that's not going to move. We know that we've got good solid wood all the way around, so we can go completely around and just get all the good solid points of contact. There. And that's never coming off. Now, just need to start assembling the framing for the linen closet now. We're just toenailing these into place, right into our structure. I know where the structure's hiding. Assembled and pre-fit these pieces, so I know where they're going. Thank you. we're out of bullets.
And with that all in place, now I can drywall that in. So anyways, this is what the finished project looks like. We've got the space for the sink and a space for some little shelves to go around, and we got underneath, we've got our place under the sink, you know, for toilet paper and stuff like that. A little kitty alcove there, so for the cat box. And that's what the project looks like for now. We're just gonna put it aside. We're gonna finish drywalling the rest of the room, and then we'll face this somehow, either with some MDF or maybe some nice pine or might even do it in oak. I don't know. Well, we'll figure it out when we get to that stage. But we're ready for drywalling. And anyways, that's a built-in custom countertop, Vanity. I'll be tiling around this area here, all around the sink, and putting up a mirror on the back there. So, but that's all for another day. Anyways, Pat the Backyard Builder saying have a good day, happy building. We'll see you next time.